Hey guys, Chris did you hear and saw Batman v Superman last night. Didn't get to review because I was a bit tired. But here is my review. First off, before I get into spoilers and all that, I just want to say that absolutely loved the movie. Did I think it was amazing? No, but I think it was great. Yes, for a score, I definitely give it an 8 out of 10. I'm gonna give some of my positive and negatives before I get into full spoiler talk and all that. So let's just get right into that. Negatives, I will say. Wasn't the biggest fan of Jesse Eisenberg's like Luthor. I liked him in certain scenes, but overall wasn't the biggest fan of his performance throughout the film. Doomsday. I didn't Doomsday, I liked the fight with Doomsday and all, but wasn't the biggest fan of his sort of build up to his creation and all that. I thought they could have done that a bit better. And I'm not going to sit here and say, oh, I didn't like Doomsday's look. I thought it looked stupid. Listen, people, it's Doomsday. Who really cares about Doomsday of all characters? So I'm just like, Doomsday can look as ugly as he want. I don't really care. He already looks like a monstrosity in the comics, so it doesn't really matter to me. As long as he has the spikes, it's okay. Which he, of course, does. Like, you can see that in the trailer and all that kind of stuff. Another negative, I guess I could say, is Another negative, I guess, would be some of the build up to the Justice League. Not fully. I really liked what they did with it. I really like how they executed that, but I don't know. Maybe it's not really a complaint. Maybe I just want it more. So that could be it. Another negative, definitely some of the pacing throughout the movie. You could see some people online saying that the editing is really weird in the beginning, and I'm like, what does that really mean? And when you see the movie, you really see know what that means. Like, I say up until the stuff happens with Clark at the big court meeting and all that. The editing was really, really weird because it's like you're watching this one scene, and then you're going to another scene. It's like, wait, what was this happening? Wait, what's going on here? Wait, what's just happening? It was really weird because of like the way they transition from one scene to another and how it kind of doesn't really connect. In the beginning, it's really weird for me. And yeah, it's definitely some of the pacing throughout the movie takes a minute to really get in. So those are mostly most of my negatives right there. And let's get into the positives. Of course, Ben Affleck's Batman, favorite thing about the movie. I know some people are saying Wonder Woman steals the show, but for me, Batman steals the show. I absolutely loved him in the movie. Definitely my favorite character, and Ben Affleck kills the role. Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman, amazing. Of course, in the beginning, some of the stuff we've already seen in trailers and pictures and all that, those are cool and all, but just seeing her in the movie, seeing her as Wonder Woman and the people's reaction, like it was kind of like a lot of people were in shock and awe and oh my God, her theme is beautiful. Like when she comes in, I'm not going to say we already know how she comes in as Wonder Woman, the Doomsday thing, but when she comes in and that music starts playing, you're just like Jesus, because that her theme is the best. Her theme is the best score, in my opinion, from this movie. Best track, I could say. Her score is my favorite. Henry Cavill Superman, liked him a lot more than I did in Man of Steel. Wasn't the biggest fan of Man of Steel, and sort of Henry Cavill's performance was part of the reason for that. But that could be due to Goyer's writing and Chris Terrio maybe. Writes the character a lot better, and Henry Cavill definitely gives a better performance. You can definitely see that he's a very conflicted Superman, like he's doing the right thing, but so many people are really hating against him, and he doesn't really know if he should be doing these things or not. He sometimes questions himself, and there's times he acts like he just doesn't care about what they're saying, but in the end, he really does. And it especially comes to a point to him where that really sort of overwhelms him in a sense, especially in one scene with Child, of course, talk about when I get spoilers and all that. Another big highlight, Jeremy Irons as Alfred. Loved him. He was great. He reminds me a lot of animated series mixed with Arkham. Because of like Arkham, he's always working behind the scenes, helping Bruce and, you know, and helping him get stuff that he needs. But like animated series, you know, he has like that snarky sort of attitude to him. You know, he's not afraid to be honest to him about what he's doing. So I really like how they really blended those two together nicely. That's basically like animated series and Arkham. Putting those together basically makes the perfect Alfred. So I really like what they did there. Another big highlight would probably just be the scores throughout the movie. They're really, really good. Like I said, Wonder Woman score is my favorite thing. Is my favorite one. I like the Batman score. I like the Lex Luthor score, and I like a few other things too, but let's not get too into those. So, what else is there? What else? The fights in the movie are great, especially the Superman versus Batman in the armored suit fight was spectacular. The reason they're fighting is probably completely different from what everyone is thinking. I'll at least say that before I get into spoilers. You know, that fight was great. The Doomsday fight was absolutely beautiful. I mean, like a lot of, you'll probably hear a lot of people say Doomsday looks horrible in the movie and stuff, but I think a lot of people will agree that the fight looks amazing. Let's not give too into that without spoilers. I guess that's pretty much it for our kind of spoilers right there. So if you have not seen the movie, please leave because we are about to jump into spoiler territory. Yes, the Doomsday fight was absolutely beautiful. Seeing Wonder Woman use the lasso was great. Seeing Wonder Woman, like I was saying before, when she comes in, like when Doomsday takes her on, when Doomsday takes Batman on, you know, when Batman is trying to lure him to the kryptonite, but of course Doomsday gets the better of him, and then when he comes in, then Wonder Woman comes in and helps him, and just when you see her with the gauntlets and it's lower and you just hear the theme, I'm just like, that is literally perfect, because this is exactly how I imagined she would show up after I heard the theme. I was just like, they have to do something like that, and they did that perfectly. I love Wonder Woman's entrance. I think a lot of people were in awe when they saw her because the video was completely silent when that happened. So, yeah, great movie. Great fight. Of course, I like the reasoning behind their fight. You know, the fact that they had a reason he has to go to her is in order for them to work together to save Martha, his mother. And then, you know, of course, Batman doesn't want to listen. You know, he, of course, is trying to take him down every way he can. He's trying to use sound devices to affect his hearing, which, of course, Superman quickly takes care of. He tries to attack him with bullets, which, of course, Superman quickly takes care of. And then, of course, you know, he comes out of the fire in that scene we saw. And then, of course, he launches some kryptonite gas at him. And then, of course, that's why he's able to deflect his hit. That which we saw in the final trailer. And then, of course, for a second there, you're really thinking Batman is getting the better on him. Like, you're thinking, is this fight over or something? Because Batman's just whooping him. And, of course, Superman just sort of gets fed up with it. And then, of course, he just grabs his leg and just throws him. And then Batman is just trying to punch him. But it's just like you can hear. It's like trying to punch iron or something. You can just hear the hits coming off. And just, like, not affecting Superman. That was just great. Like, another thing with the movie is that it's a really, really dark movie. But it is a lot lighter than I thought. I did not think I would laugh as much as I did throughout the movie. It was great. It was great. Oof. Of course, the explosion thing, like I was saying, that really affected Superman. Like, just him standing there in the fire kind of thinks, like, if he's sort of just trying to take this in, being like, he can never really catch a break with these things, you know? And of course, when he sacrifices himself in the end, that's when sort of the whole world really sees who Superman really is. And they kind of really come together in that sense, of course, when he ultimately dies and during the fight with Doomsday. How did I feel about the death? I didn't felt it need to be done necessarily. Did I felt it added some emotion? Yes, mainly due to how the world reacted to it. I'm just like, wow, it took them this long to get Death of Superman on screen because they've been trying to do that for years and years now. But hey, it was didn't think it needed to be done, but could have been executed maybe a bit better. Yeah, but I don't know. Of course, you can clearly tell he's alive because, listen, even if they ended the movie without showing, you know, the dirt rising, you would have known he was still alive. Because, come on, guys, he's in Justice League. So, we know he's still alive. Of course, seeing the Justice League cameo, seeing Flash with the whole nightmare stuff happening was cool. I know a lot of people don't like that, but I'm like, it looks like Flash is from like a war-torn future or alternate universe and stuff. So of course his suit's not going to be looking the way it's going to be looking all that classic and stuff. You know, so I mean, we still had that concept art, but even then, a lot of people, quite a few people didn't like what that looked like, but, you know, we'll see with that stuff. Seeing Flash using his powers in the store was cool, because it's like, I liked it a lot more than Grant Gustin's one, but of course, that's a TV budget, you have to understand that, but it's just like, Flash just goes, take care of him, and the milk is still standing there when he goes back. Like, that's the kind of speed I like. Seeing Cyborg's transformation with what looks like was the boom tube was cool. I like that. It really shows his suffering and pain with it and how hard his father's trying with it and how he kind of breaks down at one point. I like that. Of course, the actors play Silas Stone. I can't remember his name right now, but he's a very notable actor. I believe he was in Terminator 2, so that's cool to get. Hopefully, we see more of him in Justice League because it's like, He's not necessarily a big actor, but he's a notable one. He's someone you see, you recognize him. So hopefully they bring him back in Justice League, which I really will like. Aquaman's cameo, favorite one. Just him, just the way they show his eyes and how, and they show his strength when he knocked that drone out was just like, good job, good job. That was great. The opening to the movie with the Wayne murder, I like that. Of course, like I said, Ben Affleck kills his Batman, especially. You really start to get that, of course, with the whole Metropolis stuff going on. I really like that. Another person, I did not expect Scoop McNairy's character to be who he was in the movie. He's basically this person who blames Superman for everything that's happened. And he's the reason that Superman went to the court to speak to the people and all that, because he wanted Superman to finally speak up about what's been happening and all that. So that was cool to get. Another thing people may have not noticed is that in the opening, with of course Lois and all that, the person with the taking the pictures was actually Jimmy Olsen. Yeah. Jimmy Olsen got killed off that quick. I'm not going to talk about that. But the thing I really like is just Superman just comes in and flies out. And he just takes that guy's, and Lois just like lowers her head and just like, go ahead and do your thing. And it's just like, he just takes that guy out. So yeah. Overall, love the movie. Like I said, favorite thing about the movie was, of course, Batman, second Wonder Woman, then third Superman. Sometimes throughout the movie, it was kind of, I'm going to go with that. But of course, I really, really still like Superman.
Like I said, some of my negatives were, of course, Jesse Eisenberg's Lex Luthor. Liked him in some thing, liked him in some scenes, but overall, not really. So, yeah, those are my thoughts on Batman v Superman. Of course, there will be more and more videos coming out later about a few other things, going more in depth and a few certain scenes and a few certain characters that were in the movie. And yeah, of course, probably discussion with all this stuff later. So please like, comment, subscribe, share, and help and hug my channel out there. As always, Chris the Digit, and have a great day. And tell me what you thought about Batman v Superman down in the comments below.